What was once gleefully anticipation to see each Best Picture nominee before the Oscars is now dread and the reluctant feeling of having to complete a menial and tedious chore. With each passing year, Best Picture nominees go to less and less of the Best Pictures, though the Academy still tends to throw a few that genuinely deserve it. I am thankful to say The Banshees of Inisherin genuinely deserves each nomination it has received. Directed by Martin McDonagh, whose works include the Oscar-nominated films In Bruges and Three Billboards Outside of Ebbing, Missouri, The Banshees of Inisherin is set in 1923 on the fictional island of Inisherin, off the coast of Ireland, during the final days of the Irish Civil War. Reuniting actors Colin Farrell and Brendan Gleeson with Martin McDonagh, their first time together since In Bruges, the story revolves around Farrell's character, Padraic, as he calls upon his friend Colm, played by Gleeson, on his way to the local pub. Every day at 2 p.m., Padraic makes his way to Colm's house, where they proceed together to the pub. Only this time, Colm refuses to answer the door to Padraic, and later at the bar confesses to him he no longer wishes to be friends, and that he no longer likes Padraic anymore. What follows is a humorous and bleak dramedy as Padraic tries to reconcile the two's relationship. McDonagh has made a reputation of creating humorous yet bleak films, highlighting the best and worst of human nature. Banshees is a brilliantly written and acted movie. Tackling issues such as loneliness and depression, but also the chain reaction our decisions can cause on those around us and the ramifications of becoming embittered. Banshees has been described as a dark comedy, which it certainly is, but it is also more than that. The emotion and drama are palpable, and the film is often even more grim than McDonagh's previous works, such as Three Billboards Outside of Ebbing, Missouri, which maintains some small semblance of hope. In fact, the biggest turnoff for me in Banshees is just how bleak it can be. That said, the comedy is that much more necessary due to the lack of a hopeful theme, and luckily it's handled brilliantly. There is not a scene in the film that doesn't offer brilliantly balanced emotion with a bit of levity, yet the levity never detracts or takes away from the heavier themes. The writing is just that excellent. Witty dialogue and funny banter would go nowhere, however, without the performances needed to pull it off. Luckily, the chemistry between Gleeson and Farrell is pure fun to watch, with amazing performances from both. Throw in Carrie Condon as Padraic's sister, Siobhan, and Barry Keoghan as Dominic, a bit of the village idiot, and the chemistry amongst the entire cast highlights exactly why all four have received nominations. Banshees isn't a revolutionary film. It's not above and beyond what we've seen from McDonagh, or past Best Picture nominees and winners. But it is probably one of the best crafted and most honest films made this year. With gorgeous cinematography that helps to accentuate the movie's melancholy feel, I have never enjoyed being depressed so much. Never taking either character's side, the film just tells a true-to-nature story that, while a bit exaggerated in some ways, still reflects honestly the relationship of men. I could gripe more that the film could have done more to show the optimistic aspects of the nature of masculine relationships, but I also don't think the film was attempting to take a swipe at or decry masculinity either. It's just simply an honest portrayal of a rift between friends that goes badly, juxtaposed against the ever-distant Irish Civil War winding down over the horizon. Because some rifts can't be mended. I give The Banshees of Inisherin 3 out of 4 stars.